We're going to begin this XSLT module by talking about XPath. XPath is a language for navigating XML. And we're going to use XPath to look at the XML document containing an encoding of Shakespeare's Hamlet. If you open the hamlet.xml file, which you have in your package, in Oxygen, you'll see an ordinary TEI encoded file, which you should be familiar with from earlier in the course. In this document, acts in the play are divs. So you can see a div with an XML ID and a head of act one. Scenes are also divs inside the act. And stage directions are in a stage element, and speeches are in SP elements. We're going to investigate the structure and the content of this document using XPath. XPath is a language for interrogating and navigating an XML document. XSLT, which is what this module is about, depends on XPath. Oxygen supports XPath as well as XSLT. And if you look at the top left of your Oxygen window, you will see there's a special toolbar for XPath. And it starts with a drop-down on the left with the version of XPath we're going to use. We're going to choose 2.0. And then you'll see there's a box in which you can type some XPath. And we're going to type a very short piece of XPath, which is //SP. And finally, there's a drop-down on the left of the text box where you can choose what you want to apply the XPath to. In this case, we're going to choose current file. If you type //SP and press return, you will see at the bottom of your Oxygen window a set of results. Those results are a list of all the things that you searched for. So here we searched for speeches in the document, and you'll see a list of all the speeches that it found in the bottom window. We learned from //SP that there are 1,137 speeches in the play. How many stage directions are there? Take a minute to see if you can figure out how to do that. If you search for //stage, you'll find 264 results. How many lines are there in the play? Well, if you know some basic TEI XML, you'll know that the line element is L. So if we search for //L, we'll find 2,949 lines in the document. So XPath is a path language, as you can tell from the name of the language. And the paths that we've been using, //, this is a very crude path. //SP means all of the SP elements which are in the document. We could search more carefully for those SPs. We could use the tree hierarchy of the XML document to search for /TEI, /text, /body, /div, /div, /SP, and get the same results. Look at the XPath that you see, /TEI, /text, /body, /div, /div, and try to figure out what this search is for. Take a minute to do that. You could stop the video while you test it. That actually searches for all of the scenes in the play. The scenes are contained in acts, which are also divs, which are contained in the body. So the path to the scene is TEI /text /body /div, which is an act, /div, which is a scene. What about this? //SP square brackets at who equals /Bernardo. That will find you all the speeches by Bernardo. XPath has more than simple paths. It also has functions. So here's the count function, which we're going to use later in this module, which counts the results that it finds and gives you the total. Here's another XPath, which finds you all of the scenes which have more than 20,000 characters in them. Here's an XPath that gives you the average length of all the scenes in the play. So in this presentation, we've learned that with XPath, we can navigate an XML document. We can select elements and attributes. We can find the scenes. We can find the lines, speeches, speeches by particular people. We can answer questions about the text. We can figure out how long the scenes are, who has more lines, who shares the stage with who, who's present at the same time. Lots of interesting information we can find out using XPath. And if we want to do a lot of these things simultaneously and we want to save the results as a file, then we can use XSLT. The next section is about introducing XSLT. We've looked at XPath, and we know that that's a useful tool for navigating the content of a document and querying the content of a document. But we want to create some results and save them. So we're going to use XSLT. And we're going to start with the simplest XSLT file you could imagine. Now, what is XSLT and how does it work? Basically, we're starting with XML documents. And we create an XSLT file, which is used to process that document. Then we pass the XML file and the XSLT file together to the XSLT engine. In our case, in Oxygen, it's the Saxon processor that we use. And then the XSLT engine applies the rules in the XSLT file to the XML, and it produces output in the form of text, maybe, or XML, or HTML. So let's get started. We're going to open the XML file of Hamlet in Oxygen, if you haven't done that already, and also open the file you find in your package called simplestats.xsl. So in your Oxygen interface, you should see something like this. You'll see the Hamlet file, and you'll see the simplestats.xsl file. We're going to get Oxygen to help us apply the XSLT file to the XML file. There are the two files open, and we're now going to click on the button in the top right, which is labeled XSLT, and it will take us to a different view in Oxygen, which is the XSLT debugger. If you press that button, this is what you'll see. The window is rearranged. You have Hamlet on the left, the XSLT file in the middle, and you have an empty space on the right. The empty space is where we'll see our results. So in the top left, you want to choose the hamlet.xml file to make sure that's the XML input. In the middle there, on the XSL dropdown, choose the XSLT file. And choose the Saxon PE processor, Saxon 9, in the XSLT processor dropdown. When you've done that, press the blue arrow to start the process. And you should see something like this. So what we've done is applied some XSLT to the XML file, and the results have been shown to us in the window on the right. And all we've done is count the number of speeches in Hamlet, but we now have processed that in the Oxygen interface. So an XML file plus an XSLT file passed to an XSLT processor will give us some output. Saxon is the XSLT processor that we're using. There are some other XSLT processors. Oxygen has Saxon built into it, and Oxygen has an XSLT debugger window in which you can run XSLT against XML. You can use a debugger to test your transformations live and see the results. When we processed our XSLT in the XSLT debugger, the results appeared in the window on the right. That's not very useful to us if we have a lot of calculations that we're doing or a lot of processing that we're doing, and we want to save the results to a file. We can do that by creating a scenario in Oxygen. So now we're going to create a transformation scenario, which does the same thing, but it saves the results to a file, which stays on the hard drive and which we can look at afterwards. The XSLT debugger in Oxygen is useful, but it's quite limited. It's a very narrow window. You can't look at the XML file or the XSLT file easily, and the results are not saved in a file. What we'd like to do is to run the transformation automatically and save the results to a file which we can keep and look at later. We can do this in Oxygen by using a transformation scenario, and that's what we're going to do now. So go back to the regular view in Oxygen by clicking the button next to the XSLT debugger button. And so you can see the hamlet.xml file and the simple stats file. Make sure that the hamlet.xml file is selected and click on the button which has a little red triangle and a spanner on it. That creates a transformation scenario. When you click that button, you should see this window. We're going to configure a transformation scenario. So click on the new button and choose a XML transformation with XSLT. And then in the top left, we're going to give it a name. We're going to call it Hamlet Statistics. We're going to leave the current file URL value in the XML URL box. But we're going to choose the simplestats.xsl file in the XSL URL. So what we're saying is apply the XSL file simplestats.xsl to the current XML file in Oxygen. In the transformer box, choose Saxon 9 HE or Saxon 9 PE, and then move to the output tab, and you're going to save that file, that results file, as hamletstats.txt because we're creating a text file. And then check on open in editor so that that file is opened in Oxygen when it's complete, and press OK. So now we've created a new transformation scenario called Hamlet Statistics, and we can save that and close it. Back to Oxygen, make sure Hamlet is the file that you're looking at, and now you can click on the red triangle button which says Apply Transformation Scenario. When you do that, you should see the transformation take place in the background, and then the new file should be opened. If you press that red button, you will see the text file with the results open up in Oxygen. So we've created a transformation scenario that simply counts all the lines in the play. We can add some more statistics by elaborating our XSLT. What we have right now in the XSLT file, if you look, you'll see we're counting the number of speeches. We have a caption for that number of speeches, and that appears in an XSL text element. And then we have an XSL value of element, which produces the count of speeches using XPath. We can use the same process to add some more statistics to our file. So, for example, we could count the number of acts. What would you do to count the number of acts? What would the XPath be? Well, an act is a child div of the body element. So it could be count /body/div. That would count all the acts in the play. The result should be 5. We could count scenes in a similar way. How would you count scenes? Think about that. Scenes are divs which are children of act divs. So you could count /body/div/div and get a count of all the scenes in the play. So you've seen that we can create a statistics process which counts all sorts of different components of the file. As a task for the end of this section, create a new transformation scenario in the same way you created the old scenario, but this time use the file from your package called simplestatscomplete.xsl. That's a much bigger XSLT file. You don't have to understand the XSLT. This is just a demonstration and a bit of practice. So when you've created the scenario and you output the text file and you see it in Oxygen, you should see an interesting range of statistics generated from the play. You'll see also that the XPath in the file is quite complex, but at this stage, you don't need to understand how it works. We're just demonstrating how to create a transformation scenario. Okay, so we've talked a lot about XSLT, but we haven't actually looked at the XSLT that we're using in much detail. At this point, we're going to step through the XSLT file that you've been using, the simple stats XSLT, and show you how it actually works. This is the complete content of the XSLT file. You'll see that it starts with an XSL stylesheet element, which has some attributes which we'll talk about in detail later. There's an XSL output element, there's a template element, and there's some content in there, and that's it. First of all, you'll notice that this XSLT file is XML. XSLT is a programming language, it's a functional language, but it's expressed in XML in the same way that TEI is expressed in XML. The stylesheet element has a number of namespace declarations on it. The first one is XMLNS XSL. The XSL namespace is the namespace for all the elements which are instructions in the stylesheet. So everything that pertains to XSLT itself is in the XSL namespace. And you'll see that the XSL output element is in the XSL namespace. Further down, you will see that there is an attribute called XPath default namespace. XPath default namespace. This means the namespace that will be used when we are processing XPath. Now here we've used the TEI namespace. Why? Because the XML file that we're processing with XSLT, with XPath, is a TEI file. It's the Hamlet file. So our XPath default namespace is the TEI namespace. That means when we do count //SP, the SP is in the TEI namespace. It's a TEI element. Down below that, you will see the XSL template element with an attribute called match. The match attribute here matches the root of the document. Remember, from all of our XPaths begin with a slash, and the first slash in an XPath means the root of the document. So this template applies to the root of the document. Now, the match attribute we'll talk about in more detail in later presentations, but right now, all you need to know is that we're matching the root element of the document. The XSL output element has a method attribute which we've defined as text. That means we're producing a text file. You can produce other kinds of output from XSLT. You can produce HTML, you can produce XML, or you can produce XHTML. The template is the entire working content of the file. This template is what does everything. What it does is to match the beginning of the document, the root of the document, and then to apply one process to that. All that it does is count the speeches. So in summary, XSLT processes an XML document. It consists of one or more templates. In our simple XSLT document, we have only one template. It identifies parts of the document using XPath, and it outputs another document. That might be a text document, an XML document, or an HTML document.